Hi Sai, you are coming after a very long time today, huh?
Actually, I have something very exciting to tell you.
Okay, what is it?
Actually, my father's friend is an archer and he's been inviting us for a very long time. So we had all gone there last Sunday and we enjoyed it a lot.
Wow, so you enjoyed it, huh?
Okay, so I'll tell you the story, okay? So we went there on Monday morning and then, but we were getting a little late. So Dad said, we all better go by rickshaw or we would get late. And so we reached there just in time at the bus stand as the bus was about to leave. Uncle was very glad to see us. He said, happy to see you. Sit for some time and then we can go to the orchard. After drinking some refreshing lemon juice, we went to his orchard after some time. Uvi and I were very happy to see so many green trees everywhere. Both of us would go running and then wait for the others. After they came, we would go again running after some distance.
Great! So looks like you have really enjoyed yourself, huh?
Tai, Uncle had planted all the trees in such a straight line. They looked so beautiful and systematic too. And he kept an equal distance between two trees. And there were several rows like this. And they were looking very beautiful together. After walking some time, Uncle asked us, so, Sai and Ovi, did you get tired or not? You like guavas, don't you? Let's all eat freshly picked guavas from the trees. He then distributed some delicious guavas picked from the trees among all of us. So, while eating all the guavas, we moved ahead. And there were lots of different kinds of trees, of course. It was a field. And some of them were flowering trees. He gave us a lot of information on these fruit and flowering trees. We felt really nice to see those trees and to hear about them too.
Wow!
We had so much fun.
You know Sai, it is so great to have such a huge variety of trees around us, you know. You feel so peaceful and fresh, huh?
After roaming around, we went to his house. We had some nice lunch and then we just sat talking. So after some time, Ovi and I started playing a ball game. The game was like this. We would throw the ball high in the air and then we would catch it. But Ovi, being small, could not throw the ball too high. But my ball used to go high always. So after some time, we saw the gardener watering all the trees and both of us went to watch him. The gardener was using like a small tube thing to water the plants.
Okay.
Though a broader tube was lying there just on the side. When I asked him why he was not using the broader tube to water, he answered that the lesser water came from the smaller tube and so he could water the trees in the quantity he wanted to. Water comes out faster from the smaller tube and so I can use it to water the trees which are at a further distance also, he said. This is quite interesting, isn't it?
Yes, it's very interesting.
So finally it was evening, time to leave. We started to reach home, but while leaving, Uncle gave us a lot of fruits as a treat. I kept some of those fruits in my sack, but it became too heavy to lift. So I just gave it to Father. So even after we returned home by bus, we were only talking about the trees, fruits and flowers that we saw. From that time onwards, I've been wanting to meet you, Tai.
That's great, Sai. I'm so glad that you enjoyed that day and it's really nice that you told me everything about it. But that day, you also learned maths. Do you understand how?
Wait a moment. But that day, I only had fun with Ovi. I did not study maths.
Don't get confused, okay? Let me tell you how. Suppose that we have two types of things. If we increase one of the things and the other also increases in the same proportion, then we say that they are in direct proportion. If one thing increases and the other decreases, then they are said to be in inverse proportion.
Wait a minute, Tai. Can you please explain with some examples?
Yes, certainly. See, your trip last Sunday is full of examples of direct and inverse proportions.
You see, you were late and you took a rickshaw instead of walking.
Rickshaw speed is more than the walking speed. So the time taken for rickshaw is less than the time required by walk. So our speed and the time taken are in inverse proportion. After reaching there, Ovi and you were running ahead of others, right? So in the same time, you were covering more distance. So when we increase the speed, the distance covered is more. So speed and distance are in direct proportion. Did you understand?
Yes, I understood. But you said that there were a lot of examples of direct and inverse proportion in our trip. Can you explain with some more examples?
Okay. You saw many rows of trees there, right? If the number of trees is fixed, then more the rows, the more will be the number of trees, isn't it? So the rows and the total number of trees are in direct proportion. Let us take a second example. Okay. If we decrease the distance between two trees, then we can plant more trees in the same space. So the number of trees and the distance between them are in inverse proportion.
Oh, I've understood it properly, Natai. Let me tell you some examples. When Ovi and I were playing with the ball, my ball always used to go higher as I am older than her. So when force was more, the ball used to go higher, and lesser the force, the lesser the ball would go high. The height to which the ball would go and the force for throwing the ball are in direct proportion. While watering the trees, the gardener said that the smaller the tube, the more the speed of the water coming from it. So if the size of the tube is less, then the speed of water is more. So if the size of the tube and the speed of water are in inverse proportion. I found out one more example, Tai. When I kept the fruits that uncle gave in my sack, it became heavy. So I had to put a lot of effort to lift it. So the weight of the sack and strength required to lift it are in direct proportion. Isn't it, Tai?
Correct. Now you got it. Very good.
Thank you.
Friends, now you must have understood direct and inverse proportion correctly. Isn't it? So is there direct or inverse proportion between the tube size and the water coming out of it? Similarly, if we know the quantity of fresh guavas removed from the trees, consider the number of people amongst whom these guavas are to be distributed and the number of guavas each one received. Can you guess if there is direct or inverse proportion between them?